Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at the new default font feature in Pages. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So we're looking at Pages version 8.2 for Mac, which was released on September 30th. And this version has some new features. You'll see this pop up the first time that you launch Pages 8.2, but you can also go to Help and then What's New in Pages. The main new feature here is Set Default Font and Font Size, and that's what we're going to look at. So if we go to Pages Preferences, we can look here and see this new feature. It is under Default Font right here. So we will select it, and it's going to come up with this little menu here where we can choose the font and font size. And it will tell us that this will only work for the basic templates, and it's going to affect the body paragraph style, and other styles will adjust accordingly. And we look at what that means. So here's the default font. Let's change to something else. Let's say we're going to go with Minion Pro and maybe something a little bit bigger. So we'll say OK. We can see it now appear here, and we have a change button to go back in and change it further. So let's create a new document, and we'll use blank. Now we'll test it out, and we see it is indeed Minion Pro. We can see over here under Format Style, Minion Pro, Body Text. And if we look at all the styles, we see they're all Minion Pro. So what's going on there? These styles take their cues from body text. So body text starts off by defining a font, size, other things like that, and then all of these other styles are variations of it. So if we were to change this here to title, we see it's Minion Pro, but it's bold 33 point. So that's going to happen pretty much any font that you set. It's going to take that font and then apply it throughout all of the different styles, which is great. So let's close this document and change the preferences again. And this time let's change it to 16 point. Now we'll create a new document, and when we do, we can see here that body text is 16 point now, and if I go to title, it's 44 point. So what it's doing there is it's saying, okay, the body text is larger by a certain percentage over the default, so let's make the title larger by that same amount. Let's try changing it again here with this document still open. We'll go and change it and do, say, Helvetica 18 point, and we'll see it doesn't change this document. This document is already created. But if we create a new document and then we choose the blank template, we can see that we're using Helvetica 18 point, and if we change the title style, you can see that's all the way at 49 point now. So it only changes for new documents, of course, and also it says it's only for the basic template. So here's basic. We can actually focus in on just the basic, and there are three, just basic, blank, blank landscape, and the note-taking template. So these are the three that will then be affected by that setting. Now there are a couple other small new features in Pages. Biggest one is under View. There's a new Go-To menu, and you have Go-To Next Page, Previous Page, First Page, Last Page, and Control-Command-G, and then you type a page number. None of these are highlighted right now because I don't have any text in here. Let me add some. Okay, so now when I go to View, you can see Go To, and you can see Next, Last, and Page, and I can choose a page number, say 3. And now you can see I've got Previous Page and First Page are there. These menu items are kind of hard to get to, View, Go To, and then these, but since they're there, you can now set keyboard shortcuts in System Preferences for them, which is really nice.
So in addition to those new features, you can also now add text descriptions to videos, audio, drawings, and even image galleries. This is useful if you need to include text with those objects for when you export to PDF, so those with accessibility features turned on can hear descriptions of those items. I should also note that the new Go To Page feature is available also in Keynote. Of course, there it's Go To Slide.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.